Thanks for watching TechWiki. Click the subscribe button, then enable notifications with the bell icon so you won't miss any future videos. Have you ever walked in planning on getting a reasonable sized drink at your local burger shack, then noticed that the diabetes sized one is just 30 cents more, so hey, it's just more of the same stuff and someday I'll be dead and it won't matter anyway. Well, SSD shopping is pretty much the same deal, right? Pick a model that you like, and like soda, you pay more to get more of the same stuff, minus the insulin resistance. Actually, that's wrong. The truth of the matter is that a larger SSD, even if it's the exact same model, will often yield faster performance. And this isn't just some trick by the SSD manufacturers to get you to buy a bigger, more expensive drive. Now, traditional hard drives, which store data in circular tracks on spinning disks, have what's called a head that physically moves around over the disk's surface to read or write the data that you want. This means that a mechanical disk can work only with physical information from a single location on a platter at a time, wherever that read or write head happens to be. SSDs, by contrast, work by storing data on NAND flash modules, which don't have any moving parts. So the high-speed controllers they have on board can access multiple flash modules at once in parallel. So more flash modules equals more speed. And I'm pretty sure you see where I'm going with this. When a manufacturer wants to make a particular model of SSD bigger, the most obvious way to do that would be to put more NAND flash modules onto it. Et voila! Biggest SSD is fastest SSD. But hold on a second, Linus. Why not just put lots of lower capacity NAND modules onto the lower capacity models? Well, then they could all be fast. Well, in any given generation of NAND manufacturing technology, it turns out that there's a sweet spot for the capacities of modules that they can make that deliver the best cost per gigabyte. If you go too low in capacity, then the fab still has to do basically the same amount of work to make it, and then they end up with something that is cheaper, but not a good value. To illustrate this, let's go back to our burger shack for a minute. Have you ever noticed how a large fries only costs a little bit more than a small fries? Think about it this way. Potatoes are cheap. As for the fry cooker, the cooking oil, the property lease, a teenager to dip the fry basket, all of that is, relatively speaking, expensive. And those are all costs that the restaurant incurs regardless of how many fries you ordered. That's why the menu item marked best value is usually the biggest one. Bringing this back to SSDs now, silicon is cheap, it's basically sand. And the fabrication plants, along with the people who staff them, well, those are expensive. So low capacity modules are a bad value compared to higher capacity ones that can be produced for sometimes not much more. And to be clear, not every small drive is gonna be intolerably slow. The quality of the onboard controller and the specific NAND technology being used, such as 3D NAND, which you can learn more about here, also have a significant impact on performance. So bottom line, you can get decent performance at any capacity, but by saving your pennies for a higher capacity version, you will get some additional benefits. The speed part we've already discussed, and even better longevity, since the data cells on a larger SSD won't be written over as many times in a typical home PC. This episode was brought to you by TunnelBear, the easy-to-use VPN app. When people are shopping for a VPN, one of the features they look for are kill switches. Before you connect to a network, your device actually starts to send information about itself and what it wants to do, and it tries to establish connections with all sorts of things, and there may even be other devices trying to connect to yours. Kill switches stop this behavior outright. Also, before you connect to your VPN, all of your traffic is actually unencrypted, so in the few seconds that it takes to connect, you've probably already broadcast your IP and maybe a few DNS requests or a search query. Vigilant Bear from Tunnel Bear stops all of this too by blocking all outbound and inbound traffic so that nothing leaks out before you connect. This keeps you private throughout your entire connection time, and even if your connection goes down, Vigilant Bear will kick back in and stop all the outbound and inbound traffic until it comes back. So go try Tunnel Bear for free by going to tunnelbear.com/Linus. We've got that linked below. So thanks for watching, guys. Dislike, like, check out our other channels. Leave a comment if you have suggestions for future videos, and don't forget to subscribe.